in the club with the owner. Whoa. I can walk on water, pop it like, hey, when you on top, gon' hate on you, that what they supposed to do, I don't know how to lose. Yeah. I think the Rory go faster without the roof. Hey, when you on top, gon' hate on you, that what they supposed to do, I don't know how to lose. Hey. I think the Rory go faster without the roof. Chill. 30, I might go around in 2 seconds up, I love how my money counter move. With attitude, I got a bit to and I dropped out of school. I'm going up, check my vertical. Man, I'm breaking every rule. TMZ harassing me, I got a camera crew. Whoa. I'm addicted to shopping, so everything brand new.
Everything brand new, yeah.
I'm friends with the jeweler, my diamonds like Shamu.
My diamonds like Shamu.
Hey, she like she applying shampoo.
Yeah.
Pretty face, she got a look.
She got a look, yeah.
Keep a few racks on me, I used to work in the factory. Been hating it, never bother me. I make they follow me. Teacher said that I'm a prodigy. When I'm shopping, I don't care what it's costing me. 10 bands, really, that ain't a lot to me. Turn up my swag to infinity.
Damn.
I leveled up on it.
Level up.
Yeah, I leveled up.
Hey.
I bezeled up on it.
Yeah,
I bezeled up. I ain't got top of no negative energy. I'm on a winning streak. I'm on a
free.
The devil be doing the most, but he don't ever get to me. Bring out the Brinks truck. I'm young, flying iced up. 100-yard dash. I had to run my price up. Boss your life up. I had to boss mine up. $10,000 outfit, $100. Hey, when you on top, don't hate on you, that what they supposed to do, I don't know how to lose. I think the Rory go faster without the roof. Hey, when you on top, don't hate on you, that what they supposed to do, I don't know how to lose. I think the Rory go faster without the roof.
Chill.
If the squad ain't with me, then it ain't right.
Turn to the back, try to see we weren't having that. Sit with your head, drop it out with Alabama at. That would give a trying to battle rap. Hit, be one and done. No drive, but we running. Walk up to you while you showing a stunt. Till you up that jury, that money. Playing games, thinking showing a funny. Till my young win, for me. Yeah. For the love of the bankroll, keep it busy. Don't nobody care about it. Don't nobody want to hear about it. You got problem, huh? Well, it's the same thing for everybody. I ain't gonna lie. I promise another day go by. I ain't on the grind if I ain't on fire. If it one thing I want, then it can't go by. Tryna put seat wheels on a Range Rover. I ain't finna play no game, that what you know, so if you think at the top, till I move over. Modern day Tupac, get a new hover. Know them, now come with us and down. We dodges, steady deck and clown. We chase the meal so we can butt that down. Top, but we run the town. But with millions in, with no cap and gown. We're all over, happy now. Metal throne, concrete crown. Call that line, you getting beat. Real, what veteran? What academy? Deep, still remember.
Coach, thanks. CA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Inner Harbor and M&T Bank Stadium here in Baltimore, Maryland. Straight ahead, it's a clash to decide the AFC's representative in the Super Bowl. And it'll be a great one between the Denver Broncos and the Baltimore Ravens. For a berth in Super Bowl 53, away we go. The 2019 AFC Championship game is underway. Now it's the Boise State alum, JJ. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. Now it's Ajayi. The 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
I think that's the type of run we'll continue to see throughout this game. The snow coming down, I don't expect a lot of big plays to be broken.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
All right, here we go.
Jackson on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Over the middle here to Brown. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 16 yards on that one at a Raven first. So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 49-yard line. A first carry now. This is Hill. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Catch number one for him in this AFC championship. It's a first down.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in the paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone? He's going deep for Brown. And this is caught. Touchdown, Baltimore. As his guys are in for six. And the Ravens have taken the early lead. So they take the opening kickoff and drive it all the way down the field.
And that's the last thing you want defensively. On the road, in the playoffs, and now you're down a touchdown right away.
Extra point through the snowflakes, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Fielded about a yard deep. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line.
Trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. He'll look to throw again. And boy, that one drops incomplete. But if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble. Charles, already trailing by touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10.
Hurry up, here we go.
Now back to throw. He's going to go for a big play downfield. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Past the 20. And all the way home for a Broncos score. A big play there. 76 yards. And the Broncos are an extra point away from tying the football game. Extra point from McManus is good. And we are tied at 7. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Ravens offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Now Jackson on second down. And the Broncos get there and take him down.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
So it's third and long, and defensively not a real surprise. They're in the dime.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Jackson from the shotgun. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Kevin Pierre-Lewis in there to drop him, and back-to-back sacks now bring up fourth and long. So from their own end zone here, this kicks away. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble. That could have been trouble.
I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it. He loses it. Somehow, ball finds its way back to him.
Atone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. That's Patrick. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
Watch it now, Barney. Barney.
Pressure there just right up the gut, didn't they?
Yeah, they certainly did. And, you know, when you've got so many different responsibilities as an offensive line, you got to deal with the nose tackle, the two defensive tackles or ends, and then sometimes you just can't account for everyone. The linebacker slipped free.
Green 39.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and just like that, it's third down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Able to put it through, and they take the lead here now at 10 to 7. So a good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defense is awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the three.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow. Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
Here comes the Raven offense now, ready for another possession. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The last play got just a yard. Here's 2nd and 9 from the 26. They run with Ajayi. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 10 yards there, good enough for a Raven first down.
And that's the big fella's M.O. right there. Running through tackles, keeping the sticks moving forward. This defense, if you don't bring 11 guys to the ball to try and get him on the ground, he's going to keep making runs like that. I feel the press box.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he'll grab a gain of 5 out of this up to the 41-yard line.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on run downs. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
Jackson will look to throw it. Blitz coming, and down he goes.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, they'll have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been under constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. 3rd and 11. And some extra depth to the secondary here. They're in the dime. From the gun, Jackson. And the pressure gets to him again. Von Miller, he's the one to get him this time. And back-to-back sacks are going to bring up a 4th down. The Ravens send their punter out now as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. Taken in at the 11. A big boot that time. 57 yards the official distance. And it'll be 1st and 10 Broncos from deep in their own territory. The Broncos offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns. I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable 2nd down. A very solid gain on that play.
Here we go now. Blue Lanny. Blue Lanny. Watch it now, Barney. Barney.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And they'll get him down here at the 23. 7 yards there. Good enough to move the sticks.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of their yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another 1st down with that run.
he'll play action here on first down. Fighting his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
So second in inches after that first down completion went just shy of the marker.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. Hurry up. Here we go. 319. 319. Back down to that Philly. Here we go. Gone, gone. Gone, gone.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give them a new set of downs.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football.
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. They'll look to throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Fake. They'll look to throw. Going up top. And that's caught inside the 30. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And that one results in 35 yards. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. To go here in the first half. Back with more of the AFC Championship game after this.
Back down to that Philly. Here we go.
Now they'll run it on the toss. No, bottled up. Fumble. It's out. It's loose. And it's picked up by the Ravens.
Thank goodness for heaters up here. And thank goodness I don't have to carry the football in this game. It's January. It's cold out there. Trying to clutch the football and absorb the hits. Not easily done.
Yeah, we saw a product of the elements right there. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. After the fumble recovery, it's Jackson. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Von Miller in there for the sack, and it's an important one from a personal standpoint, as that is sack number 100 in what has certainly been a terrific career to this point. They come up on second and long, and the pass protection just has not been there this afternoon. Good move, but for a short gain out near the 32. Only a yard there on the keeper, and that's going to leave them with a third down.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
He may try and run for this. Give him an even gain of 10, but now it's fourth down. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. The Ravens send their punter out now as he'll come on to kick this one away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. This is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. Now this Broncos offensive unit ready to head back out onto the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
And they'll run it here. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. And now the Ravens are going to take another timeout as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. The Broncos on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. Looking to throw. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. As the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Now a play fake here on 1st down. Forced out to his left. Now he'll throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey. Bust through the tackle. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. That late in the clock, 2nd quarter, why not just run it a time or two and get it into the locker room?
What you're saying makes absolutely perfect sense. Run it and get out of there. But I'm just wondering if the pressure of today's NFL and the high-powered offenses that you're facing may have forced them into saying, let's try and get some more points.
Watch it now, Barney! Barney! Gun! 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 Gun!
After the interception, here's Jackson. He's going to wind up and air it out. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down.
It went with a dime look on defense. 2 extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on 2nd and 10. Again on 2nd and 10, it's Jackson. He's going to loft one deep left side. That's caught inside the 20. And they're going to have this way down deep in Denver territory. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. First red zone chance now for the Ravens. They're looking at a 1st and goal Patriot, from about Patriot. The 9.
All right, here we go. 3-19! 3-19! Gun! 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 Gun!
From the gun, it's Jackson. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. Another shot from the nine on second and goal. Whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. So a jump there defensively.
That's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
Here's another second and goal, this time from half the distance closer.
Gun, gun!
Whistles here and a flag down. Looked like someone got going a little early. Things made a little more difficult after the false start as they try again on second and goal. To throw again is Jackson. Dancing to his left. And he'll just throw this one over in the way of the security crew. Incomplete here. So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And this has no chance. Yeah, who has time for a halftime show with a trip to the Super Bowl on the line? Let's get back to it. So we are halfway home to figuring out who will represent the AFC in the Super Bowl.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10.
Watch it now, Marty, Marty! Here we go now!
Now a handoff looking right. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Right back to him on first down. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. Back to throw here. Left side here to Sanders. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, it kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
Couple of plays sent them the wrong way, and now they face a third and 14.
Patriot! Here we go now. Blue 90! Blue 90! Watch it now, Barney! Barney! Hot! Hot!
He'll look to throw. He's going to let this one go deep. That's caught inside the 20. And all the way home for a Broncos score. A big play there. 50. 33 yards. And the Broncos will extend their lead. And when a Hail Mary is completed for a touchdown pass like that, I think any defensive coordinator just puts their face right into their hands.
I don't think there's any doubt about it, and I don't have stats in front of me. I don't have the empirical numbers that say that in recent years the Hail Mary pass has been completed more than it has been, but it feels that way, doesn't it? And I know the defenses are spending more time on it. I think the biggest mistake they make is that they play everything from behind the receiver. I think they've got to start getting people in front as well to try and knock the ball away.
The Ravens offense getting ready now for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use. Just something to get you off to a quick start.
And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. The drive will start with an option going left. And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield. But it looked like a Raven was able to get in there, and they will indeed keep the possession.
And a little bit of good fortune there. He wasn't able to get it back, but he did have a teammate on the spot able to retain possession for them.
From midfield now, here's Jackson. A dump off now to Hill. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
Well, that was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now a first down carry. It's Hill, and he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Brandon, we're into the second half, and this offense has not scored a lot of points, and that was another example of why. I think it's time to open things up and start really trying to move the ball.
They'll go option on second down, right side. Flash the stick skills on that run, but then stop shy of the 35. He's able to call his own number for 8 that time, but it leaves him with a third down.
Hey, hey, hey. You got 4.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
Gone. All right, here we go.
From the gun on third down, Jackson. And open, that's Jaleel Scott. Tally, that is catch number 1 for him in this AFC Championship. It's a first down.
And that one was a lot of fun right there because that was the game within the game. Third and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now Jackson on first down, looking deep downfield. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete. They have not gotten him going at all. Tried to spark something there with a longer throw, unable to complete it.
But you have to keep trying. He's one of their best playmakers. No matter what it says on the scoreboard, you're always trying to get him the football.
Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. Back to the ground, it's Hill. And room there to work it inside the 25. Second down, a little more productive than first. 7 yards on the gain. It gets him to third and 3 now. They missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range on third down.
Leopard! 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 Gone! 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 Gone!
Jackson looking to throw on third. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And the broken tackle helps lead to a first down gain. Tally, that is catch number one for him in this AFC Championship. It's a first down. Zone now. Here's Jackson on first down. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. The Raven passing game getting in sync. Another first down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They'll come out in the pistol. They'll try to run it in, going option right. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. Jay Ajayi, a five-yard touchdown run. And the Ravens have cut it to within a score. That option pitch we saw, we don't witness a ton of that in the NFL, but it worked there down near the goal line for a score.
And it's actually a great call in goal line situations because as more and more quarterbacks enter the league with that mobility and having run option in college, more pro teams are adding it to their arsenal. And now it's not just, does the quarterback run it? Does he pitch it? Now they've added that third element. He can rise up and throw the ball as well.
And Denver getting set to take the field. They were able to extend their lead with an opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter, but that just got matched a moment ago.
So we know that what they discussed at the half worked. Now, what are the counters to that, right? You don't just run the same things over and over. Some do, but many will also show something and then come back with something else to keep the defense off balance.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Steps away to his left. Looking for Sanders here on the deep ball. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. To throw now on second and 10. Wide open receiver complete. The 30. And he finally goes down at the 23-yard line. A huge play there for Denver. 52 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now back to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. A great play there from 21 yards away. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. Extra point was hooking, but he does make it through. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Now McManus on to kick this one off. This is fielded a couple yards deep. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. And now here come the Ravens. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minute. Who knows? We'll see what they decide to do.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at about the 32. Jackson on first down. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Scott. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
Throwing now, Jackson on first down. He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack.
Gun,
work
gun,
to be done.
Gun, gun. Black 99 Philly, here we go.
Jackson from the shotgun. And an alley to run. And he will avoid the contact as he slides to a stop. A breakdown defensively there as the scramble is going to set him up with a much more manageable third down. I thought they were going to sack him there like they did on first down. Great coverage, but he found a way to move with his legs.
Yeah, his ability to take off. Not only did he get some yardage back, he got a little bit extra. Really helps him on third down. Makes it manageable now.
From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw. Underneath here to Hill. The Raven passing game getting in sync. Another first down. Yeah, two-score game, obviously. Every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified. Big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get the third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down.
This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again, to the tune of 7 sacks in this game thus far.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down.
Gun, gun! Gun, gun!
From the gun, Jackson. He goes full extension, and he's got it. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down.
I know you don't get anything extra for degree of difficulty, but maybe you should. He's done absolutely everything in this game today, including laying out for that one.
The Ravens on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be 3rd and 5. Operating from the gun, Jackson. Flush to his right. He can run for it, and he will. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. Nowhere to go downfield, but he's able to get out of bounds and stop the clock here with a first down.
Containing him is becoming a big problem. We've already seen this once earlier on this drive.
Yeah, and so now 2 times this has happened. Do you adjust something?
Yeah, I think you do. I think you got to start thinking about your rush lanes. Try not to either get too wide or too narrow. Make sure someone is there waiting for him to take off.
This is Ajayi. And power running here down to the 6-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the 4th quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down 4th quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. The Ravens on third down. They've hit four of seven. They're up against a third and one situation. They come out five wide. Three of them to the right. Got a man. It's caught for a Ravens touchdown. A great effort there from 3 yards out. And the Ravens draw a bit closer. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game. And you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
Shotgun. He'll look to throw. And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming.
Right, now,
this is third
56.
And long.
Lucky 56.
They'll drop the throw. He sets the fire deep. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Earl Thomas. And a big return will get him all the way down to the 35. A critical error there in a tight game of the fourth.
All you talk about is taking care of the football, and especially with a lead here in the fourth quarter. Turning it over, now the door is open for the opposition.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter at what point, you got to be super careful.
You got to be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuck that one behind the line of scrimmage.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. And incomplete there. A nice hit jars the ball free and brings up third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll try the option on third down. He may try and run for this. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And Tucker's kick right there. It's good. But hang on, a flag is down. Now, if it's on the defense, they might decline it and take the points. Well, forget the field goal to try to tie this thing. They'll have a chance to take the lead here with first and 10.
All right, here we go.
From the gun, Jackson. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Time for a break. Back to wrap up the AFC Championship game after this. Now Jackson on second down. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off inside the five. And not much on the return there. He'll take it only up to the 9-yard line.
Well, I don't think we'll have to look very hard to find our play of the game. That was an absolutely monstrous big play right there. Backs to the wall. The offense has it in the red zone, driving for the winning score. And he says, not on my watch. And that is one happy bunch on the sidelines.
Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. This defense starting to buckle down when they need to, and right now they're winning this fourth quarter, losing the game, but they're winning in the fourth quarter.
And what a fine line it is about what they're trying to get done, because they're down, so they obviously need the football, need a score, but they can't be so aggressive as to give up their edge, their gaps, and have the offense hit them with a big play.
Back to the ground, this time with Freeman. And he'll find some room to get this up to about the 14. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. As he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. To the 13. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. Well, he had 2 sacks earlier. Now he has 4 total tackles for a loss after that play.
Well, they obviously have to do a better job trying to block him. But short of that, you know what the quarterback has to do? Make sure he doesn't hand it to him when he's back there thinking he's one of his own guys. His quickness, his suddenness, his speed getting into the offense's backfield has been something else in this game.
Forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Taking it about the 36. A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And the Ravens, they'll take over. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. They're only in need of a field goal. A decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. He's back to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he will find Scott on the right side complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A gain of 32 that time. Back to throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Detroit! Detroit!
Back to throw. And his throw here is incomplete.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle, got to totally command it, make sure all eyes are on him, all focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
Big play coming up. Here's 3rd and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
Lucky 56. Lucky 56. Leopard.
They'll look to throw. And that one drops to the ground. Incomplete. Clock stops here just inside of 20 seconds. 19 left.
There's definitely contact there, but it's the fourth quarter of a kind of tight game, and sometimes officials just say, let them play. Kind of like your mom used to, and you and your brothers just take the broom to you and send you out to the backyard and tell you to settle it yourselves.
I like that. Yeah, there was contact. I don't know, like you said, enough to warrant the flag. It was close, though. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This to potentially send us to overtime. And Tucker's kick right there, it's good. And that will tie this game here in the final minute of the play. So in the final minute, they turn it over to their kicker to get him back to even, and he does not disappoint.
Brandon, do you think the pressure ever gets to this guy? Because I sure don't. That was pretty smooth right there. But I tell you, he better not rest on his laurels, because there's a good chance they may need him again if this game goes to overtime.
Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. Fielded about a yard deep. Pretty move. And now running right through it. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. In a tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. So now with 6 seconds remaining, we get a timeout on the field.
Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. They've got his man complete. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Cortland Sutton finding the end zone on the game's final play. And the Broncos have broken the tie. The extra point is good, and on the final play of the game, they walk away with a victory. Really a great season, not a whole lot to hang their head about.
Not at all, and you know, the winning side, they're so ecstatic, they're going to the Super Bowl. But for the guys that we're talking about, they've got to figure out how it's going to go next year. Are they going to be motivated by this loss? Or will this loss linger and really make them, you know, make it tough for them to come out of the gate strong next year? Only time will tell, but they've got to find a way to use this loss and use it as motivation.
Hey, hey, what's up, gang?
Let me go secure for the game right quick.
Hey, what's up, gang?
I got it.
I think it's my fault.
For real.
What's up,
the rest.
Hey, I got that taken to go.
I'm gone.
A lot of these really lost.
They
broke. They think it's my fault. No car. I want that car. I'm tripping. I'm stuck with the sauce.
Good drip. Good drip.
But she love you. Don't cut your.
Yeah.
Reynolds
yeah.
Da Vinci is white.
Yeah.
Raping the Louis, that's light. Rape in the city,
that's light.
LED, look at the light. We the ones don't like.
Don't like.
But you look too
light.
Why even play with your life?
Your life.
Bank account looking like yikes.
Looking like
I went from feeling all kites to putting it in my block. Lou Gucci sweater is drip.
Drip.
Somebody give me a.
Drip.
These ain't like the cops. Gossiping more than. taken to golf. A lot of these was lost. They broke. They think it's my fault. No call. I want that. I'm tripping. I'm stuck with the sauce. When she love you, don't cut your. Reynolds Da Vinci is white. Limited Louis, that's light. On the city, that's light. LED, look at the light. We the ones don't like. But you look like. Why even play with your life? Bank account looking like me.
With me, boy. Put your hands in your fingers. Put your ears with a. Get back, watch you turn to a singer. Get it fighting like this Jerry Springer. All of my. Just back that like a popo. They popo. Had a G-Wagon truck turned to Rojo. Find a cable, two wheels, and they. Won't ride down to Soho. One's black and the other was Mexican. Had a. Like a pollo. Younger than you with a Maybach. Younger than you with a Bentley. Finna. Got. In the. Gently. Angry and friends with these. When I was down out of soul had sympathy. Facts. But that's how I go when you broke. Facts. Now I'm hot like mistletoe. This you, my own. Not gonna lie on these new clones. Then she asked for a loan. Had to laugh, then I told her get gone. Go and get this me on. Ain't no give me not a thing. So I'm spending 90K on my ring. You can see all my pain in my watch. Got my ex down and walk around with my hand on my. Cause I'm popping and I know you not. And I know you see just how I'm living. You're not happy with life, so you. Rockin' Reeboks on treetops, getting walk. Got a big Benz like Sasquatch. Every time you see it, what if no, it's talking
about? I got that taken to golf. A lot of these was lost. They broke, they think it's my fault. No call. I want that call. I'm drippin', I'm stuck with the sauce. But she love you, don't cut your. Reynolds Da Vinci is white. Limited Louis, that's light. Rape in the city, that's light. LED, look at the light. We the ones don't like.